Hello, my name is Eleni Myrtsioti and I am one of the moderators of this MOOC. In this tutorial, we are going to explain how you can register an activity in the EU CodeWeek website and how you can report it back. Registering activities on the interactive map of the website is one of the most important things you have to do, as it is a way to help us get an insight of how many participants were involved in the activity. Registering and reporting back the activity is compulsory if you want to get the Certificate of Participation validated by the European Commission. During the 2018 campaign, almost 44,000 activities took place, and thanks to the map, we can not only measure them, but also have an insight of events organized per country and what those events exactly were. This interactive map is being updated every year, so we can measure how many activities were organized during each annual CodeWeek campaign.
What is an activity? A CodeWeek activity is any planned action that you take in order to bring coding to others. As a teacher, you can, for instance, browse our tutorials, choose one of them and replicate it with your students. You can also do a webinar or an online presentation in order to talk about CodeWeek, but also organize a regional, national or international competition and invite other teachers to join. Examples of activities include a pan-European interactive webinar on CodeWeek, just to present the initiative to other teachers. You can also ask your students to create a collaborative and even multilingual game with Scratch with students in a different region or countries, which could be very fun and engaging for them. You can create or participate a treasure code hunt with teachers in other schools or countries. There are unlimited options when it comes to activities and things you can do in order to participate in EU CodeWeek. Even if you don't have a computer or a good, reliable internet connection, you can still do an unplugged activity. If you decide to do so, you will find different examples on our website. You have to go to codeweek.eu, click on the schools page, scroll down a bit, and access the training modules. There, you can find the learning bit Coding Without Digital Technology, Coding Unplugged, designed by Alessandro Bocliolo. In that learning bit, you can find 3 different lesson plans, which you can download for free and adapt to your students' needs.
A very nice activity can also be an activity you try with your students in the school's courtyard, or something that would include far more participants, like the code hunting game Alessandro Bocliolo organized in 2018. If you want to know more about this, make sure you visit this website, codehunting.games. For other inspirational activities, you can visit the blog on the CodeWeek website or the Facebook group that we have specially created to host the community of teachers in order to get ideas of activities. In the CodeWeek blog, you can also find different activities other teachers have already done before. Have a look to get some inspiration. blog.codeweek.eu. And if you are not part of the Facebook group yet, please feel free to join in order to stay tuned to the latest news about CodeWeek. The name of the group is EU CodeWeek Teachers. In this group, you can also find many ideas and inspiration for activities you can do with your students. How to register an activity? The first thing you have to do in order to register an activity is go to the CodeWeek map. The activities map can be found if you click on the activities section in the website. Next, click on the Add Activity button. If you don't have an account yet, it is going to redirect you in this page. It is going to ask you to log in using your GitHub, Twitter, Facebook or Google account. Additionally, you can register by using any email address that you want and a password. Once you have created this account, it is going to redirect you in this page. In this new page, as far as you can see, there is a form which needs to be filled in by you. In this form, you have to fill in the date of your activity. You have to mention the activity title, the name of the organization, the type of organization, if it is a school, a library, a non-profit, the activity type. You also need to provide a brief description. You need to provide information about the audience and the theme of the activity. Additionally, you need to provide data such as the address of the activity, as in where will the activity be taking place, the country, the starting and ending date, It could be a 3 hours activity, it could be a 4 days event. If you have a website, feel free to fill in this field. And of course, we would need you to fill in your email. You can additionally use a personalized tag to be used in order to track down easily your activities. If you register more than one, it would be very useful for you to use a personalized tag so you can track down all of them easily. Similarly, if you have a codebook for all code that you would like to use, there is a field for that too. It would be good if you could provide a customized picture, graph or logo in order to be used as a thumbnail for this activity that will be displayed in the scoreboard. This is going to be particularly useful in case you have registered more than one activities. Lastly, we would need you to provide a contact email that will be available only to the Codeweek coordinators and ambassadors. On the upper right part of the page, you can find the How to Organize the Event link. If you click on it, you will be redirected to a different page with brief, useful information that summarizes what it has been discussed here. How to report back and give us the necessary data for your activities. Reporting your activities once you have done them with your students is essential if you want to receive the certificate of participation validated by the European Commission. In order to access the page that will allow you to report, you need to click on your profile in the upper right part of the page and scroll and click on the Report Your Events section. You will be redirected in a new page, codeweek.eu/events-to-report, that will be customized and will include the event or events you have organized with your students and previously registered on the map. Click on the event that you wish to report, and then on the button Report Event and Claim Certificate. It will redirect you to a page with a form displaying a different number in the hyperlink for each activity. Once you fill in all the necessary data, you can click on Submit Event Report, and then download your certificate, which you can print. Be careful while filling in the field name of the certificate. Whatever you mention there will be used for the certificate. If you make a mistake, you can contact the coordinators at info@codeweek.eu and then they will fix the name that you wish to be displayed on your certificate. Once you register an activity, and as soon as it gets approved, you will receive a confirmation email. In addition, you will also receive frequent reminders to make sure you don't forget to report the activity and get your certificate of participation. So now that you know how to register an activity, give it a try. Choose one of the lesson plans in the Codeweek website for schools or any other resource and organize an activity with your students. We are looking forward to seeing many activities in the Codeweek map.